Okay, so our topic for today is all about photosynthesis. So photosynthesis, ito na, kung nakikita nyo yung meme on this side of the slide, yan. Okay, so humans, we do a lot of activities and our bodies do a lot of repairing and other activities inside, creating of protein, synthesis of other molecules. And in order for our body and in order for us to do these activities, we need energy. And for humans, we are called as heterotrophs. Heterotrophs are organisms who don't have the ability to create their own food. Therefore, we humans, we have to eat other organisms in order for us to survive. That's why on the meme here, it says that humans, they eat food in order to survive. Pero when it comes to plants are a different kind of organism. Plants are what we call as autotrophs. Specifically, there are autotrophs. Autotrophs are organisms that have the ability to create their own food. And for plants, they are specifically called as autotrophs because they have the ability to use the energy coming from the sun, energy from the light, and convert it into food that they can use to use for their energy to power the other cellular activities that they are doing. So, sulat ko na lang on our Jamboard. So, yung mga important information natin. Specifically, autotrophs. Okay. So, again, humans are called as autotrophs. Heterotrophs, and then your plants are photoautotrophs. Autotrophs specifically, photoautotrophs. Kasi sila yung ang ginagamit ay energy from the sun. Okay? And take note of this molecular formula. 6 carbon dioxide plus 6 water, and then it will be converted into sugar, specifically glucose, C6H12O6, and 6 molecules of oxygen. And later on, we will check kung paano nga bang na-convert ng plants itong carbon dioxide and water using the energy from the sun into a chemical form of energy, which is your glucose. Okay? So let's start with the topic of photosynthesis. Okay. Before we start with photosynthesis, we have to look into the organelle that is only found in plant cells, which allows it to do photosynthesis. And on this part of the slide, you can see a plant cell. And inside this plant cell is what we call as your chloroplast. Okay? So chloroplasts are organelles that are only found in plant cells. And they are special organelles because they contain the green pigment chlorophyll. And this chlorophyll is the pigment that allows the plant to absorb the energy coming from the sun. So without the chlorophyll, your plants will not be able to absorb the energy coming from the sun. And again, this chlorophyll is found inside the organelle that we call as your chloroplast. So ito yan, this is your chloroplast. And inside a plant cell, there are actually multiple chloroplasts. Okay, so on the picture, you can only see one, but in reality, there is it's possible for a single plant cell to contain multiple chloroplasts. Okay, so the reason why it's colored green is because it contains the green pigment chlorophyll. Okay, sulat ko na din in case you need to write it on your notebook. So inside the chloroplast is what we call as your chlorophyll. And the picture on this side is what a chloroplast roughly looks like. So your chloroplast is double membrane. So if you can see here, the chloroplast has its own membrane. two layers of membrane. The first one is the outer membrane, and then we have the inner membrane. Okay, so as if syempre, because this is a membrane-bound organelle, then it is only found in eukaryotic cells because eukaryotic cells contain membrane-bound organelles. Okay, so other than the outer and the inner membrane, we also have several structures inside your chloroplast. So the first one is your stroma. Okay, so take note of this part. So the stroma is the aqueous fluid inside the membrane of your chloroplast. So the white part here, we are going to assume that this is a fluid that is found inside of the chloroplast. And we call it as your stroma. Okay? And in this stroma, you can find structures. They look like coins. Okay? Coins or spherical chips that are stacked upon each other. When we say stacked upon each other, ibig sabihin patong-patong sila. So the individual coin, yung nag-iisang bilog, is what we call as your thylakoid. Okay? So the individual circle here or the individual coin is what we call as thylakoid. When it is stacked up on each other or pag patong-patong sila, one thylakoid, there is another thylakoid on top, and then another thylakoid on top, then that is what we call as your granum or grana. Okay? So again, we have the inner and the outer membrane of the chloroplast. Inside the chloroplast, there is a fluid that we call as your stroma. And then in this stroma, you can find this thylakoid. The thylakoid is the circular coin-like organelles or structures inside the chloroplast. And when they are on top of each other, then that is what we call as your granum. Okay? So the reason why we are learning about the different parts of the chloroplast is because different stages of the photosynthesis happens in different parts of the chloroplast. So the first part of photosynthesis, the one that requires light or what we call as the light-dependent stage, happens in your thylakoid. Okay? So it happens in the thylakoid. But the second part of photosynthesis, that the part that does not require light, we call it as the light independent stage, happens in the fluid or in the stroma. Okay, so let's write this down. We have the light dependent stage, and the light dependent stage happens in your thylakoid. Coming from the word light dependent, it means that it depends on light, therefore it only happens in the presence of light. So this is what we call as light-dependent stage. It happens in your thylakoid. Okay, so it happens in the thylakoid. Let's put an arrow para hindi kayo malito. Okay, so the light-dependent stage happens in your thylakoid. Okay? Whereas the second part or the second stage of photosynthesis, it does not need light. Therefore, it can happen any time of the day. If there is no light, then the light independent stage will happen. So coming from the word independent, meaning it does not need light. So it happens in your stroma. Okay? So don't forget about these parts and which part of the photosynthesis happens on which part of the chloroplast. Okay? So before we move to the next stage, can I get a thumbs up sign if so far we are clear on the different parts of the chloroplast? Walang thumbs up sign, therefore walang nakaintindi. Si Miguel lang. Who else? Is it clear or do we need to learn about the different parts again? Okay, so in this visible light spectrum, we have different colors here: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. And each color contains different levels of energy. Okay, so the red here has the higher wavelength, therefore it has the smaller amount of energy. Whereas your blue, indigo, and violet here, these are the colors that have the shorter, mas maiksi yung kanilang wavelength, therefore they contain more amounts of energy. Now you have to understand that these colors can be absorbed or it can be reflected. So as you can see here, this is one photon of light and it will reach your thylakoid. Now you can see this here on the visible light spectrum, some colors are absorbed by the thylakoid, but some colors are not absorbed by the thylakoid. So yung hindi niya inabsorbed, it is actually reflected. Okay? So here, the thylakoid, it absorbs the colors red, orange, yellow, blue, indigo, and violet. Okay? And then, it reflected the color green. So ang nakikita niyo dito, yung rainbow ninyo is absorbed by the thylakoid, except for green. The green color is actually reflected. So, nag-bounce off siya doon sa thylakoid. And that is the reason why when we look at plants, when we look at leaves, we see them as colored green. So, kaya sila kulay green sa paningin natin is because all of the colors from the visible light spectrum is absorbed except for green. Green is reflected. Therefore, green is the one, the color that hits our eyes. So, yun yung nakikita nating color when we look at your plant. Okay? Again, when it comes to photosynthesis, it uses the energy from colors, all of the colors in the visible light except for the color green. So, yung green, hindi niya inabsorb, ni-reflect niya yon. Pero inabsorb niya yung energy coming from red, orange, yellow, blue, indigo, and violet. Okay? So this is the absorption of light. So bakit kailangang i-absorb ng chlorophyll itong energy, itong colors na to? It's because kailangan niyang gamitin yung energy that the colors contain. Okay? They have to use the energy from this light so that it can create its own food. So now let's go to the actual process of photosynthesis. And the first part of photosynthesis is what we call as your light-dependent stage. Ayan na. Okay. So your light-dependent stage is a part of the photosynthesis or a stage of the photosynthesis that requires light. So, kailangan niya ng light coming from the sun. Therefore, we can conclude that the light-dependent reaction only happens during the day in the presence of light. Okay? So, the light-dependent reaction happens during the day. Does it mean that photosynthesis stop at night? The answer is no. Kasi after the light-dependent stage, it is followed by the light-independent stage. So the light-independent stage does not need energy from the sun. It does not need light. So pwede siyang mangyari even during, even at night na walang ilaw. Okay? So as long as there is energy available from the sun, the plant will continue to do light-dependent stage or what we call as the light-dependent reaction. Okay? So let's start dito sa picture na nakikita ninyo. Again, please look at the picture and take note. Lalong-lalo na yung process na mangyayari. Okay? So, in the light-dependent reaction, it happens in your thylakoid. So, nangyayari siya sa thylakoid. So, in this picture, this is the thylakoid, yung paikot na bilog. And inside the thylakoid, ito yung inside ng thylakoid. Okay? And then here, on this side, yung medyo nasa taas, this is what we call as the stroma. So, ito yung fluid part, yung gel-like structure, ito yon yung nasa taas. And then, ito yung membrane ng thylakoid na paikot. So, nandi yung nasa baba is the inside of the thylakoid. Okay? Sige, isulat na din natin para hindi na tayo nalilito. Okay. So, the outside of the thylakoid is here. The inside of the thylakoid is the one at the bottom. Yung nasa taas is what we call as your outside of the thylakoid or your stroma. Okay? Stroma, ayan. Stroma. Okay? And then, ito yung membrane niya. So, it's very similar to what a plasma membrane looks like. If you will remember your plasma membrane, meron siyang phospholipid, tapos meron siyang protein. Tama ba? Okay. Di ba meron siyang integral protein at saka meron siyang peripheral protein. So, kamukha niya yung thylakoid. Okay? But, instead of integral protein, we have what we call as your photosystem. Okay? So, the photosystem, these are the structures na itong kulay green, ito, PS2, kung nakikita ninyo, at saka PS1. So, yung PS1, ito yung PS2. So, PS stands for photosystem. Okay? So, these photosystems are the structures that contain the chlorophyll. So, the light that hits the plant cells are absorbed in these photosystem, yung absorption of energy from the different colors of the visible light spectrum is absorbed here in your photosystem. Kaya kung makikita nyo sa picture, parang merong lightning dito na nakadrawing, ang label niya ay light, saan siya tumatama? Doon lang sa photosystem 2 at saka sa photosystem 1. Because these structures are the ones responsible for the absorption of the energy coming from the visible light spectrum. Okay? So, the first thing that happens in your light-dependent stage is that your photons of light or your molecules of light will hit your photosystem 1. So, kapag naarawan yung halaman ninyo, that the light will hit this photosystem and this photosystem 2 will absorb all of the energy from that photon of light. Okay? So, pag na-absorb niya na yung energy coming from the light, the energy will excite this electron. Okay? So, when we say excitation of electrons, it means that what we are talking about is we are changing your electron from low energy to higher state of energy. Okay? So, in the beginning, your electron here started with a very low energy. Okay? But the more light your photosystem absorbs, the higher the energy or the state of energy of your electron is. So, mas tumataas ng tumataas yung energy na nakocontain itong electron na to. If we're going to make an analogy about it, this is like charging your phone. So when, at the end of the day, usually yung mga phones ninyo is low battery. Meaning, konti na lang yung energy niya to do all of the applications or the processes that you do with your phone. Pero once you charge it, tumataas yung amount of energy that is contained. Ganun din yung inyong electron. The more light your photosystem will absorb, the higher the energy of your electron is. Okay? And because of this energy coming from the light, that is absorbed by your photosystem too, it can also do what we call as it has the ability to split your water. So if you can see here in this picture, originally we start with one molecule of water, okay, so H2O, and because of the energy coming that is absorbed by the photosystem, it allowed water to split into two. So nahati siya into hydrogen ion and oxygen molecule. One oxygen molecule. Okay? So as you can see here, dito pa lang sa photosystem 2, from the absorption of energy from the light, your plant is able to produce oxygen. Nakakapag gawa na siya ng oxygen, which we need. So hindi kailangan ng plant ng oxygen. So ang nangyayari is, the oxygen here will go out of the plant. And nangyayari yon, or nagagawa ng plant yon, it is able to create oxygen by splitting water. Sulat na natin. So, para hindi kayo malito. So, yung energy that is absorbed from the sun is also used for the process of splitting of your water. Okay? So, nahati niya na yung inyong water into hydrogen ions and oxygen molecules. Okay? And then, continue pa rin itong photosystem 2 to absorb the energy coming from the sun until your electron reaches yung pinakamataas na kaya niya nang i-absorb na energy. So, if we're going to make an analogy about it, this